Hey everyone, welcome back. My name is Mitro. I'm the author of Decoded Frontend channel. Here you can find a lot of advanced Angular tutorials and tutorials about web development. In this video, we're going to continue to talk about structural directives in Angular. We will have a look at the more advanced stuff and we will learn what is context and how it can help to make our directives and templates more flexible. If you have never worked with structural directives or you have very little experience, I would highly recommend you to check out the previous video where we had a look at the very basic microsyntax for this kind of directives, so you will get some context and necessary knowledge in order to understand better this particular video. If you had seen it already, then stay tuned and let's get into the details. All right, let's continue to work on our awesome structural directive, which removes some HTML template after some period of time and replaces it with another HTML snippet, so-called placeholder. And previous video, I ended up talking that it would be cool if we could assign this value for our hide after directive to some variable using as notation and save it somehow like this. And then we could reuse this variable somewhere in our template. As example, instead of this hard-coded 5 seconds, we could place this value here and it would be rendered dynamically. Of course, if we save it right now, we see nothing because we have to adjust it a little bit. And namely, we have to introduce the context for our template. And let's jump to our directive, and the context which you can provide is the second parameter of create embedded view. If you hover over it, you can see that the first one, it's a template reference, and the second param is context. And context, it could be literally any object like this, and here you can define some variables, whatever, but we're going to remove it and we implement it slightly differently. I'm going to introduce the separate class for our context. I'm going to introduce a new class which I will name hide after context, and then we will create the instance of this class somewhere in our directives. So I will name it context, and it will be the new instance of this class. And then we can use this context as a second parameter for our create embedded view method. Here we go. But because our context is empty, we see no difference, obviously. So let's introduce a new property here. And here, pay attention. In order to make it work with this syntax, with this as keyword, we have to have inside the context the property which is named the same as a selector for our directive. All right, guys, during the post-production, I realized that I said some bullshit. So to be more precise and avoid misunderstanding, I just wanted to mention that the context property should not match the directive selector, but rather directive input where you want to use this as keyword. So sorry for the inconvenience. Sometimes when I do multiple things at the same time, I say something different from what I really think. And now let's get back to the video. So if we introduce such a property and let's, I don't know, define 1000 as a default value, just to see the difference, you can see that now it was rendered inside our template. because now value from our hide after property was assigned to this variable, which we have reused. So let's make it zero by default. And now we have to slightly adjust our input right here. And once we set some value or value for the hide after input changes, we should update the property for our context, in order to have the proper value. So I would suggest you to refactor this to the set. So I will introduce the private property called delay, but next to it I will create the setter for delay property. Here we go, and here we have some value which might be either number or null, right? Because we could use async operator, and async operator might return null as well. So let's keep it a bit more generic. And here inside the setter, I'm going to first update the delay property, and namely what I want to assign here is value, or if it is null or undefined, then we have to say that it should be zero. This is the nullish coalescing operator.
Nullish coalescing.
Also, I want to set the value for our context, and for hide after, there will be assigned this delay as well. And we have to also update it right here. Here we go. And now we have to read proper value. But as you can see, we have here 5000 milliseconds. I would like to probably convert it to seconds. So I will divide it by 1000. So yeah, it looks way more better. So it will disappear in 5 seconds. If we change it to, let's say, 7000, then it will be removed after 7 seconds, which is great. So I hope it is clear with S keyword right now. And the next feature I would like to implement is, I would like to have some counter, you know, so somewhere here should be a counter down like 4, 3, 2, 1. So user could see when exactly our template will disappear. I think it would be a quite useful piece of information. So I would like to introduce a new property in our context, and I will name it counter, which is also zero by default. And then every second, I would like to just count it down. Yeah. So inside ng onInit, right after creation of the embedded view, I will set interval where every second I will be mutate our counter from the context and decrease it by 1. So here we go. But of course, we have to clear our interval once we stop to count, right? Otherwise, we'll get memory leaks. So I will save the set interval ID into some constant, like interval ID, right? And then once we cleared our embedded view, I would like to clear my interval like that. Nice. Now our counter is being updated, but how we can show it within our view? So let's switch to the app component. And after my then, I would like to introduce a new variable, and it starts with the keyword let. Then I name it, let's say, counter. You can pick any name you would like to have for this variable. And then we are going to assign the variable from our context. And namely, we would like to assign this counter. So I copy it and paste it right here. So now we can type something like it disappears and namely in whatever seconds. Yeah. So if I save it like this, we can see that we count down, but we count from the zero. Ah, sure, because we have to assign this value also for the counter inside our context, like that. Here we go. Now if we save, yeah, we see the proper counter. Okay, it already looks great, but let's move forward, and I would like to show you also how to read context variables, not for our main template, but we also have this second one. We have this placeholder, so we would like to read also some variables there as well. And in order to do it, you have to also provide the context. You can either create a separate context for the placeholder view, but I would reuse my currently existing context, and I can provide it right here. So I can save it, and then let's go to our placeholder template, and here we can read variables from the context as well, but the syntax is slightly different for the ng template. So if you want to introduce the variable, you have to also start with the keyword let, but instead of space you have to use dash, and here you can define any name you would like to have. Let's say we will name it hidden after. And then you have to use the following syntax, and between those quotes you have to provide the property you would like to read. In my case, I would like to have hide after. Yes, so in my placeholder I would like to render how long the previous content was visible on my page. Okay, so here I could write something like it was visible for, then my variable hidden after, and then I can say seconds. Oops, I have a typo here. Here we go. And now if I save it, we see the counter. This is our first view, and then inside our placeholder we see that it was visible for 5 seconds. So obviously if I replace it here, it will be dynamically changed, and instead of 5 seconds we should see, yeah, it was visible for 7 seconds. That's already awesome. And let me show you the last thing for today, is how to provide some default value for our templates. And the way you can do it is to introduce the special property called $implicit. So like that. And you can define any value there. I don't know, 1000 as example. Yeah, we will do it more dynamic in a few seconds. But what I want to show you, that this implicit will be default value for your template. As example, you can see that here we explicitly define that this variable should be mapped with this property. But what if we want to have something like just my default value? And now when I try to render it somewhere here, and if I save it, you will see that once the placeholder is rendered, you can see that this 1000, which we define as a value for implicit. Okay, but in our case, I would say that it would be more useful if this hide after would be our also implicit value. So let's maybe make it as a getter, like that, and we just return this hide after value. So now our implicit value is equal to this one, and we will see the 5 as a value for this variable, for this my default. Of course, you can read also default value, this implicit value for the context in this micro syntax for our structural directive. What you have to do is to introduce the new variable, call it, I don't know, whatever you want, and that's it. And you can reuse it somewhere instead of time, this example, because in our case, time and default will be absolutely the same values. And you can see that, you know, everything is working fine. And this is some of the cool features which Angular templates allow you to do along with the context and along with structural directives as well. All right, guys, that was it. I hope you also impressed how powerful might be structural directives in Angular. And if you learned something new today, please share this video with your colleagues. It extremely helps my channel to grow. It motivates me to create more videos like that. And of course, don't forget to leave your thoughts in the comment section. Also, don't forget that I have video courses which might accelerate your career as Angular developer. Check them out. Links will be in the video description as well as coupon codes. And I wish you a productive week ahead. Stay safe and see you in the next video.